Hi, everybody. Welcome to Squirrel Pie Productions, my podcast about knitting, spinning, and sewing. My name is Tommy, and you can find me on Ravelry as Dynamite Trujillo and on Instagram as Squirrel Pie Productions. Welcome to episode 9 of my podcast. I am really happy you decided to join me today. Welcome to all new and returning viewers. It's so good to have you here. I'm really excited to talk with you today about some things that I've been working on, some things coming up, and thanks for being here. We do have a Ravelry group that you're welcome to join if you haven't already, under Squirrel Pie Productions on Ravelry. It is where you will find the show notes for this episode and all previous episodes. It's also where you'll find all knit-along happenings. So go check it out if you haven't already. It's fun over there. Today is a Friday in February. It is a rainy, foggy day here on the Northern California coast where I live. And it's nice. I like it. I love rain. It's raining pretty hard right now, so that's good. Good excuse to stay inside and knit. So today I'm drinking some coffee out of one of my very favorite coffee mugs. It's giant and it's sassy and I love it. And I'm gonna show it to you now, so I'm gonna warn you, there's cursing on it, so expletive warning. I won't say it, but it's this one. I have seen many variations of this around town that people use, and I love it. I purchased this mug directly after I watched an old episode of the Made with Carlinergy podcast, which unfortunately is no longer being recorded. But she was drinking out of this mug one day on her podcast, and literally I paused it and went and bought it. It's from a potter called Pollock Designs, I believe. I'll link to them in the show notes. I'm actually not sure if they have a website. I know that they will be vending at Stitches West this year. They vended there last year too. They make some really cool stuff. They make mugs and yarn bowls, and they all have this kind of placket where they put fun knitting things on their stuff. So they're great. I love this mug. It's giant and it's really beautifully glazed. I really am a sucker for I really love ceramic, dishware, pottery sort of stuff. So I love this mug and it's got my coffee in it today. I'm actually pretty caffeinated right now. I'm pretty excited about what's coming up. I had an unexpected car adventure come up this morning. So I pretty much just got home from going out on like an hour and a half long car adventure, drinking coffee and listening to Lord, who is a pop singer. So I'm kind of pumped up on her music and caffeine. I'm ready to go. I'm ready to start this day. It's Friday, my favorite day of the week, and I am going to now show you what I'm wearing. I am wearing my River Cowl, which looks like this. This was made in Knit Circus Yarns. It was part of a kit that I was given as a gift. Is that grammatical? I got this kit as a gift. And I made this cowl. It's Knit Circus Yarns, and it involves a gradient and a natural cream colored yarn. The cowl pattern is called the River Cowl, and it's inspired by a character from one of my very favorite television programs, Firefly. River is a character on Firefly, and this cowl is named after her. The gradient yarn is called, I believe it's called Also I Can Kill You With My Brain. And then the cream is got some other name that's helpful. It's called like Creamy Sheeps or something like that. So this is my Firefly cowl. I don't remember who the pattern was written by. I will link to it in the show notes though. But I think it's like a Knit Circus pattern. And I love it. It's a wool cashmere yarn and it's very nice feeling. It's very soft. Very squishy, very luxurious. And it's pink and purple and blue. I love it. And I don't have any FOs this week. I did not finish anything, but I do have some whips that I'm going to share with you. I will start off with some socks, is what I was going to say until I remembered. I have not talked about the knit along yet, so I'm going to do that now. Did I tell you we have a Ravelry group? I did. So in that Ravelry group that I have already told you about, we have a knit along going. It's a sock knit along. It's called the Contrast Cal, hashtag Contrast Cal, Contrast, K-A-L. It is where you, if you would like, will knit along with me and the other group members a pair of socks, or more than one if you would like, out of yarn with contrasting heels, cuffs, and toes. So that's the basic requirement. Any yarn you want, any weight of yarn you want, any size socks you want for you, for your kids, for your baby, I don't care. As long as it has contrasting heels, cuffs, and toes. So it's been really fun. A lot of people have been putting their stuff up on Instagram and in the Ravelry chatter thread in the group. I've really, really enjoyed seeing what you guys are working on, and keep it up. I want to see more. I want everybody knitting on socks, everybody using contrast heels, cuffs, and toes. Do it. It's fun. It's so fun. I've been having a really good time with my socks. I did see there are a couple new sock knitters joining in on the cowl, which I'm so excited about. You guys rock. You guys are so awesome. I'm so happy you're taking up sock knitting or giving it a try. You may like it, you might not like it, but I'm really, really happy you're giving it a go. So keep it up. Join up if you haven't yet. We do have a couple of prizes that I am really excited about. I will show you the first one now. It's a skein of Hey Holly Ho Hum yarn. And I got this for you guys because it's amazing. And I really wanted to get her yarn to you because I love it so much. And here it is. So one lucky winner of the Contrast Cal will get this skein of yarn. It's Hey Holly Ho Hum in her MCN base in the Desert Dawn colorway. It's beautiful. It's speckled. It's amazing. There's her tag. You'll also get this little sheet pin. So this is going to go to one randomly drawn person from the FO thread in the Ravelry group. Also, I'm going to be giving away one winner's choice of a pattern on Ravelry up to $10, so that'll be fun too. So there's an FO thread and a chatter thread in the Ravelry group. Show me your pictures of what you're working on in the chatter thread when you're done with your socks. Post in the FO thread and you'll be entered to win this or a pattern. So that's that. Contrast Cal. Join it. So now I'm going to show you some whips. And I guess the first whip I'll show you is my entry into the Contrast Cal. Those are my Luna and the Thestral socks. And it is out of my own hand-dyed yarn. Sorry. I'm getting a thank you text from the person who caused the adventure that I went on this morning. So, I gotta respond so that they know. Thank you. Farm animal emoji, farm animal emoji. Bird emoji. Oh, fish. Blowfish. Snail. Octopus. Okay. So, my Luna and the Thestral socks. This is out of my own hand-dyed yarn, which is really exciting because this is pretty much the first skein of yarn that I've ever dyed well. And here's the first one. She's my hoe, and I love her. So this is a top-down sock. I cast on 56 stitches for my socks, knit a 2x2 cuff, and a size 0 needle. Switched to a size 1 for the main body. slip stitch, heel flap, and gusset. And the contrasting color I did on the slip stitch, heel flap, on the heel turn, switched back to the main yarn for the gusset stitches, did the foot, and then switched back to my contrast yarn for the toe. And the toe is my kind of personal standard rounded toe with a Kitchener finish. So like I said, the main yarn is my hand-dyed yarn in the Luna Lovegood colorway, and the contrasting heels, cuffs, and toes is Woolen Vine Yarns in the Nevermore colorway on her Blitzed base. And the Blitzed base is, I believe, Merino Nylon and Stellina. And then my hand-dyed yarn is on a 4-ply sock weight base, 100% superwash merino. And I love how this sock came out. I'm so excited. I think it's beautiful. And again, I will explain. Luna Lovegood is the colorway for the main body of the sock. That's what I named it. And Luna and the Thestrals is Luna. And then this color for the contrasting heels, cuffs, and toes represents the Thestrals, both of which are characters from Harry Potter. Some of my favorite characters. The Thestrals are beautiful, invisible flying horses, and I love them. And these socks are doing me really well in letting me triple dip in some knit-alongs. So first of all, I am using these for my own knit-along, the Contrast Gal, and then I'm also using them for Katie of Inside Number 23's Harry Potter knit-along for February. And also my box of socks, which is a knit along hosted by Kristen of the Yarngasm podcast and Woolen Vine Yarns. This is my second pair of socks that's going to go into my box of socks. There are some really good sock knit alongs going on right now. There are a couple more that this doesn't qualify for, but I'm determined to get some more socks on the needles so that I can enter them all. I love knit alongs. I love sock knit alongs. And I want to knit a couple more to qualify for the other ones that are going on right now, too. So this is the first sock. The second sock is coming along. I'm on the leg right now. There she is so far. And they're fun. I'm loving working on them. Here is the cake of the main yarn. This is the Luna Lovegood colorway that I dyed. That I am super excited about. I've been having so much fun with dyeing lately. I will show you some more of that later. So this is kind of a mauvey purple with blue and black speckles. And then the Woolen Vine Yarns in the Nevermore colorway looks like that. It's this beautiful tonal gray. It's one of my favorite grays, which I use kind of a lot. I've noticed it's like a stone gray where it's kind of brownish gray, or has tones of brown in the gray. I really love it. It's really, really pretty. And in here, I have my cute little cheat sheet that I got with a coloring book yarns order a long time ago with the Kitchener on it. I love this. I like to keep it handy. And this, of course, is living in my fat squirrel chicken bag with the chickens on the inside and the outside. So Luna and the Lovegood socks. I've been knitting on those a lot. They've been a lot of fun. Next pair of socks I have on the needles is my Neon Tiger socks. This is another hoe. So I've got one done. And it's beautiful. I love it. It's super bright, so My camera kind of doesn't know what to do with it. But it's muted neons, which is what I'm calling it. It's got like mint greens and pinks and yellows and tealy blues. This is what it looks like in the cake. I love it so much. It's so bright and happy. This is another Stellina base. This is Hey Holly Ho Hum Yarns. And I love it. Colorway is called Frankly Lisa, which is why I call the socks my neon tiger socks, because Lisa Frank life. And these I did same exact way as my Luna and the Thestral socks, 56 stitches, 2x2 cuff, stockinette sock, heel flap and gusset, rounded toe with Kitchener finish. And I love them. They fit great. I did the cuff on a size 0 and the body of the sock on a size 1. And both of these are done on Hiya-Hiyas. This one is a Hiya-Hiya Sharp. And my other socks are being done on just regular Hiya-Hiyas, not the Sharps. So I'm about the same place on these as I am on my other socks. And these are going into my box of socks. Pair number 3, I guess. I don't think they qualify for any other knit-alongs. So I love these. I got 2 hoes. So excited. Let's see. What do you think about that color? No? They just look super bright, don't they? There we go. Look at that. I love these. 2x2 is definitely my favorite rib. FYI. And these are living in my Neon Cats bag. By Bull & Vine Yarns, and I've got my version of the sheet pin from Hey Holly Ho Hum on here. So I have been knitting on socks a lot lately. That is kind of mostly what I've been wanting to do, is just stockinette in the round. And I have been working on a couple of other projects. My other big project is also just stockinette in the round, so that's been really fun. Next project I have going on is in my Gastly's bag. Are you guys sick of seeing my same 5 projects project bags over and over again? Because I use the same ones all the time. So this is my Paint the Town. It's a shawl that I have been working on for a little while now. A few weeks, a couple weeks, not that long. But I am making slow progress on this. And here she is so far. This is the Paint the Town shawl, pattern by Jumper Cables on Ravelry. It is a long rectangular stole type shawl. And I'm using, right now, Madeline Tosh BFL Light in the Solo Speckles teal colorway. And it's got a center double decrease running down the middle, which I love, love, love. I love the center double decrease as a design feature. And it is all garter. The pattern was written for a stockinette shawl, but I switched it to garter because I like it. And I'm using a size 6 needle for this, right? Yeah, size 6 from my Hiya-Hiya interchangeable set. And this type of shawl normally I love, and I would really be zooming by on it. Size 6 fingering weight garter shawl, straight rectangle with the center double decrease is kind of my favorite. But this yarn, like I have said in past episodes, is incredibly sheddy, so I can't work on it that much. And I worked on a pretty good bit of it last weekend. And then I had to put it down because I started feeling like I was maybe getting a cold or something. And this was really irritating my sinuses, so I couldn't work on it. So I haven't worked on it in about a week. But I really love how it looks so far. It's just hard to work on because it hurts my face to work on it, kind of, because the fibers just fly everywhere as I work on it. But the yarn's really beautiful. Like I said, Madeline Tosh, BFL, in the Solo Speckles colorway, teal colorway. That's that one. The second color that I'll transition into is the same yarn, unfortunately, because it's hard for me to work with, but it's Madeline Tosh BFL Light in the Peppermint Patty colorway. The third color, which I cannot wait to get to because I think it'll be a lot easier for me to knit on, is not a single ply base. It's a sock yarn from Hedgehog Fibers. And it's the Exploding Peacock colorway. And this is really, really pretty. I can't wait to use it. So we'll see how long it takes me to get there. I've got a lot left to do, and I really want to make it happen. It's just hard. I can feel it. I can feel it happening already. So that is my Paint the Town shawl. We're gonna get there on it. I may start another shawl in the meantime, which I don't generally do. I don't usually have more than one shawl going at a time, but this might have to be a back burner sort of shawl. We'll see. My last, second to last work in progress is my Rosalyn tunic. Rosalyn is a pattern by Veronica Avery, written for Brooklyn Tweed. And here is where I'm at on that. This I'm really enjoying. I love working on this. This is Jill Draper Makes Stuff Yarn in the Hudson base. The colorway is Pacific. And this is a bottom-up tunic. I started with a 2x2 ribbed cuff. Cuff isn't the right word. The ribbing is at the bottom. 2x2 rib. I started with a tubular cast on and a size 6 needle, went up to a size 8 needle for the body, and I have just started the waist decreases. So this has been really, really, really fun. I love this yarn. This little ball is all I have left from my first cake. And I have my second skein here that I have not wound up into a cake yet, but that will be coming up soon. So this is Jill Draper Makes Stuff. The Hudson base is a superwash merino worsted weight yarn. And it's really beautiful. It's got a high twist. It's really bouncy, really springy. And it's in this really beautiful, muted, kind of seafoam colorway. I love it. I love it so much. I've got 5 skeins of this, so this is my second skein. And this is just so fun to work on. It's a really easy pattern from the looks of it. Bottom up, stockinette in the round with waist decreases. Once I get up to the armholes, I'll do the sleeves separately, bottom up, attach the whole thing, and do a yoke from bottom up yoke thing. It calls for a turtleneck to be put in. I don't know whether or not I'll do the turtleneck yet. We will see. It does also have short sleeves, but I am hoping to do just above the elbow length sleeves. So I'll have to do a little bit of modification. We'll see when I get there what I do. I'm not sure yet. But here's a picture of the pattern. That's what it looks like. And I'm really excited about it. I love tunics. Kind of my favorite style of top to wear is a tunic. And I think this is going to be really, really cool in this yarn. It's a really nice worsted spun, kind of solid yarn. It calls for Brooklyn Tweed, the pattern does, which is a woolen spun, much airier, lighter, foofy yarn, which I love, but this is what I have, and I think it's going to look really good in this, too. I think this thing's going to be heavy, which is cool. I don't mind. It gets cold here, so it'll be good. And I have been working a lot on this because I really love it. And it's living in my Fat Squirrel Dead Birds bag. I did have a little oopsie poopsie with that pattern when I first started. When I was doing the tubular cast on, it has a lot of steps that cast on does. And one of the steps is rearranging all of your stitches that are on the needle. So you have a series of stitches and you go through the whole round and you take a stitch off the needle, move a stitch, and then put a stitch back on the needle, kind of like doing a bunch of cable things just around the whole round. And that took a while. It was kind of a pain to do. And I got to the end of the round of rearranging my stitches and realized that it didn't look right, and I couldn't understand why it didn't look right. And it took me about 5 minutes to realize that what I had done, excuse me, was I did my repeats wrong. So you know in a knitting pattern when there's like a set of instructions that you have to do throughout the whole row or round, and it'll have like in parentheses or within stars, the repeat. And then before the repeat, there's like one thing you need to do at the beginning of the round, and then you repeat what's within the stars for the rest of the round. Well, I was supposed to do something like that, only instead of repeating what was in the stars the whole round, I repeated the whole thing all the way around. So I messed up. And I thought I was going to have to just rip back the whole thing and start over because it seemed really complicated to rearrange my stitches throughout the whole round. I thought I was just going to mess up and it was going to be horrible. But I tried it. And it worked. It took like an extra half hour to do, but it worked. And so I rearranged them back to how they were at the start, started from the beginning, and then went around again and rearranged them all again correctly. So that was fun, but I'm really glad I noticed my mistake and was able to fix it. A lot of times, like I've said in previous episodes, I'm not a perfectionist in my knitting or spinning or anything, and a lot of times I'll find that I've made a mistake and I'll just say, oh well, and I'll keep going. And I thought about doing that with this, and I'm really glad I didn't, because it would have been really obvious. It would have been like super obvious, so I'm really glad I went back and fixed it. But it was kind of a pain, because the whole cast on takes a really long time because it's so step intensive. And I just like added like two really long steps to the whole process. So, but I'm really happy with how it looks now. I'm really happy I went back and fixed it. And now it's over and I've moved on and the whole rest of the thing is like super easy. So we're good. We're on track for my new tunic. And then I've got my blanket. This is my granny stripe crochet blanket living in my other fat squirrel bags. This one's got a goat on it and a skull and flowers and a blue pom-pom. And most importantly, a teal zipper. So this has been getting a good amount of love this week. Okay. I zipped it up into my zipper. That's when you know you need to put your project in a bigger project bag. Because it doesn't fit in the one you have anymore. Okay, I'm going to lose some pliers. Look what I did. Oh, well. I snagged it. I snagged my blanket in my zipper. It's okay. Hello, Granny Stripe Blanket. You are enormous. Yay. So this is where I'm at so far. This is how long it is, and I love it so much. I have got my ever popular sprinkled donut. Can you see? Can you see? You can probably see. Let's say you can see. I love it so much. I love it so much. So I've been using fingering weight scraps in my granny stripe blanket. I have been using a size E crochet hook by Tulip. And I love it so, so much. Right now, what I'm working on, this top color, is some Jameson and Smith, the fingering weight one that comes in these little 25 gram balls. I love this so much. And this is kind of my, what I do in the evenings while I'm watching TV or whatever, and I love it. It is so fun, it's so mindless and easy, and it's the best. I've got a whole bunch of scraps in here that I am working on. This was a swatch from a sweater that I made some time ago. And this is Sincere Sheep in a fingering base. I think it's a Rambouillet wool. It's 100% wool, and I love it. This is some of my favorite yarn I've ever used in my entire life. And I've got a sweater made out of this in this pattern. And this was my swatch, and I decided I'm going to rip out the swatch and put it into my blanket. Because why not? And these are the scissors that I keep in my blanket bag. This is some Knitmore Girls swag that I got at some point. Super cute. So I'm just kind of doodling along on this, and it's the funnest thing ever. I hope you're making one too, because I want you to have as much fun as me. It's getting pretty big. It goes really fast. It goes like really, really fast. Every time I work on it, I'm surprised at how much bigger it is than it was last time. So I have a lot of really beautiful yarn in here. I really love this. I love it a lot more than my Cozy Memories blanket, which is a goner now. She no longer exists, and her former glory is going to end up in here at some point. So after the zipper disaster of 5 minutes ago, I have decided I am going to upgrade this to a bigger bag. I'm not even going to zip it back up because I'm scared, since I snagged that last piece of yarn. That's everything I've been working on knitting-wise. It's been a really fun knitting week. I've been waking up a little bit earlier than I normally do in the morning to go to work. I usually wake up at like 6:15 in the morning to go to work, and I've started setting my alarm for 6 instead of 6:15, so I can do a little extra knitting in the morning before I go to work. And that's been really nice. 15 minutes isn't that much less sleep to get, and it kind of amounts to a lot when it comes to being able to knit that little bit more each day. So that's been nice. That's been really nice. And I love being up in the early morning, kind of before the day has started, and doing my own thing. I did finish my spinning that I was working on a couple episodes ago. That is my loop bump. It was the Femme Fatale colorway, and it's done. Here it is. So this is a single ply yarn. It is so bright. Oh my God, the camera can't even handle how bright this is. It's a gradient. It came out so much thinner than I thought it would. This is like a lace weight, but it's a single ply. It's my first single ply I've ever done. And normally my standard, what just comes out of my fingers when I spin, is a lace weight single, to try to go for kind of a fingering sport weight yarn. I was hoping to do a fingering weight single though. And it's fingering weight in spots. It's really uneven. It's really uneven. It goes from like cobweb lace in some spots to like almost a sport weight in some spots. But check it out. This is 4.3 ounces. And I got 980 yards. 980. This is so much yardage. So, oh my goodness. Come on, camera. What the heck? So there's kind of the gradient. It goes from this hot pink, which damn, that's super hot pink on the camera, to this like kind of rose mauve color, to this deeper mauve color, to this burgundy, to this, there's a deep purple right in here, and then the last color is this, again, stone gray that I love so much. So that's really exciting. I'm really excited to use a gradient in a project. I don't know that I've done that before, except for this, hello. But I have a couple ideas of what I'm going to use this for. It pretty much balances out to be a lace weight, I think. Though looking at it, I feel like it could be a fingering weight, too. I'm going to try to do this thing that I see some people do in podcasts. I don't know if it's going to work, because my camera is kind of sucky. But, can you see that? No? Not. So that's what one of the plies looks like. It's thin, but it really does look like a fingering weight in a lot of spots. It's kind of like a light fingering, but I can't believe how much yardage I got. 980 yards. Also, though, I use my Knitty Knotty to collect my yardage data. And this probably isn't the most accurate thing in the world. One time around this is 2 yards. And who knows? Who knows if I really get an accurate reading? And we kind of just have to trust. I always kind of like count my yardage and then assume that I have a little bit less than that. But this is really beautiful. I love how it came out. I did spin it a little less tightly than I would normally spin a single. And then when I soaked it, I did thwack it, which is something I don't normally do. And thwacking it pretty much means when it was wet, I wrung it out to dry, and then I took it and I banged it down on the towel that I was drying it in a few times, which pretty much felt it a tiny bit, adding to the structure of the single ply, I think. This is all what I think it's supposed to do. But it came out really, really nicely. It's really nice. It's really soft. It's really, I don't know how to describe it. I'm really excited to knit with it. I'm really, really excited to knit with it. Let's see if you can see a little bit of the ply on here. A little bit. And this was, like I said, a loop bump in the Femme Fatale colorway. Loop bumps are not my favorite things to spin. And that is because they are beautiful. They're really beautiful. And they create these amazing gradients. But what I don't like about them is that they essentially feel like when you're using the fiber, it feels like it's pre-drafted fiber. And I don't pre-draft my fiber. I don't like fiber. I don't pre-draft my fiber. How about that? I don't like drafting from pre-drafted fiber. It feels like I don't have very much control over it when I do. I end up with a really uneven ply that way. And I always feel like I'm like pulling it out and it's like, whoa, sometimes a little bit comes out, sometimes a lot comes out. I'm like, whoa. I don't know. I just feel like I don't have that much control over it when it's pre-drafted. So I don't like working from pre-drafted fiber. And I feel like loop bumps, as you use the fiber, as it's coming out of the bump, the way she prepares it, it feels pre-drafted, which a lot of people love. I don't. And that was one of two loop bumps that I have. So I still have a second one to spin. And I'm going to enjoy it. And I know that it's going to come out really beautifully the way this one did. But I'll wait a while on doing that one. Give myself a little break from the pretty. But God, look at that. Oh, I love it so much. I have been doing one of my favorite things, which is obsessively browsing Ravelry patterns to try to figure out what I'm going to do with this. And I was expecting to get like 600 yards of a fingering weight. And I got almost 1,000 yards of kind of a heavy lace, I guess. So my plans were kind of deterred by what I got. But I found a few patterns that I think will probably work. I can do one of two things with this the way that I've decided upon it. I can either just use this, or I can stripe it with a neutral lace weight or light fingering single ply. My original intention when I was going for a heavier fingering was to stripe it with Tosh Merino Light in the Gossamer colorway, which you've seen a lot on this podcast before. But I think that might be a little too heavy. So Madeline Tosh does have a lace weight single. I think it might be called Prairie. I don't know. I'm pretty sure they've got a single ply lace weight yarn. So I can get that, hopefully in the Gossamer colorway, and stripe it with this and see what I can do. Or I can just use this straight up. And the patterns that I came up with when I was browsing Ravelry are two Stephen West shawls, the Dotted Rays shawl or the Jag in Garter. I think those would both be really cool in a gradient like this. Also, Amba O'Brien has a pattern called the Inara Wrap. And that calls for two gradients of two different colors that you use together to create a really cool sort of striping effect. But what I would do if I did that pattern is use this gradient and then use a solid or tonal color like that Madeline Tosh for the small stripes in it. There's also the Cloud Wrap, which is a lace weight stole by Helen Stewart. And I do have that pattern. So we'll have to see. We'll have to see what happens with this. I really want to cast this on like right now. I was saying earlier that I want to get another shawl on the needles so that I have something to work on other than my Paint the Town shawl. And I want to do something with this. It just depends on what I decide on. If I decide to use this by itself, I can cast it on right now and start something. And I think one of those Stephen West shawls would be really cool. Dotted Rays, I think, would be awesome in this. So I might do that. But if I did something to stripe it, I would have to order the other yarn and wait for it to come. So we'll see. We'll see. I do really, really love it, though. I'm so happy with how it came out. I had never spun a single ply yarn before, and I'm super happy with what I did. I love it. So So there it is in the skein again. That'll be coming up as a whip soon. I might cast it on today or tomorrow. I don't know, we'll see. I did also do some dyeing last weekend. That was a lot of fun. I pretty much took a bearskin yarn and split it up into 3 gram minis, and I used each mini to dye each color of dye that I had, so that I kind of have a reference of what every color looks like when I just dye it by itself. So that was really fun. And then left over was like 40 something grams from that skein. So I did a little mini skein on its own. And when I was done dyeing each color individually, I did a little, I don't know, reel dyeing with the leftover little skein. And this is what I came up with. It is this purple with pinks and blues in it. And it's just a teeny little mini skein. But I'm hoping it'll be enough for a pair of socks for myself. I don't use that much yarn in my socks. And I'm really happy with how this came out. I think it's really, really pretty. I used some pinks and blues and grays on this and did some like kind of mucky green speckles. And I'm really, really happy with how it turned out. So I'm pretty sure I can get a pair of socks out of this tiny little ball if I do contrasting heels, cuffs, and toes. So this might be my next entry into my knit along. I'll just have to find a good color to contrast. Maybe I'll dye something up, I don't know. So I spent a pretty good amount of time dyeing last Friday after I recorded, and so when I dye, I wear a respirator mask, so I can't really tell what's going on around me sense-wise. When I took off the mask, though, after I was done dyeing, my house stunk. Like, it smelled bad, and it was from the dyeing. And I'm not really sure if it's just how the dyes smell or how wool smells. It's not the wool, because I've gotten wool wet before. But so I'm not sure if it's the dyes and just how they smell when you're using them, or if it's my pots. But dang, my house smelled bad. I had to air it out quite a bit for quite a while. But I dyed for a long time. I was probably dyeing for couple of hours, and I got 2 stainless steel stock pots for dyeing, but I got them from the thrift store, so I'm not sure if it's them or not. I may have to bite the bullet and invest in some brand new stock pots. I was really stoked when I found these stock pots because they were like 40 cents each. And they are stainless steel, I know that, because it says it on the bottom. But they're old, and they had pretty bad staining in them, which I was able to scrub out pretty well. But there might just be some stuff in there that stuck around, and I might have to buy new pots. Because I don't know if that's right or not. I don't know if it's supposed to smell like that. I hope not. If it's just the dyes, and that's how they smell when you dye with them, I might have to get a garage set up. I might have to buy a couple little electric burners and move my operation to the garage, because I don't know if I'm gonna continue having a husband if I keep dying in the house the way that I had to do it the last time. But it was worth it because I came up with this beautiful yarn, and I'm stoked. I'm really happy with it. I would show you the little minis that I made out of all the colors, but they are pretty precariously set up right now because I've got all the names written down, but I haven't like actually attached them to the little mini skeins yet. So if I move the skeins, I'm going to lose the names and blah, blah, blah. So I'm going to leave them where they are. but here's my little purple coup, my little purple skein. I like her. So for my favorites, I'm going to show you what I hope to bring along on my vacation that I'm going on this week. I leave in a couple days to go to Hawaii for 5 days with my husband. I'm really, really, really excited. Yesterday was my last day of work for a week, and I'm so excited to have a little time off of work. And I want to take, I think, two projects with me on vacation. I want to bring a pair of socks and a shawl. I'll only be gone for 5 days, so that's not that much knitting time, especially because we're probably going to be out doing stuff most of the time. But I am going to have two really long plane flights. I'm not positive, but I think it's about an 8-hour flight, and I will probably get a lot done on those 8 hours. So I want to bring a brand new pair of socks so that I can have the whole pair to start and finish while I'm gone. And I'm not positive what I'm going to bring yet, but this is my idea right now. This is some Fiber Nymph Dye Works. This is a self-striping colorway on her Bound Space called Six More Weeks. And this was a club colorway from 2015. And it's pretty springy. It's got greens and pinks and purples and yellows. And I thought it would be pretty fun to bring these as my socks. So I might be doing that. If I haven't finished my other two pair of socks by the time I leave, I'll probably bring those for the car ride down to the airport. The airport that we're using is in Oakland, which is like a five-ish hour drive from where I am. So I'll have the drive and the plane ride. So I'm gonna bring the socks I'm working on now for the drive, leave those in the car, and then take these on vacation. And I also, like I said before, want to start another shawl, and I want to bring a new shawl with me on vacation. I don't think I want to bring the Paint the Town shawl because I don't want to bring that fluff irritation with me. So I might cast on my handspun for a shawl if I can figure something out. And if not, I'll figure something different out for some other stash yarn. And if I do these socks, I can join in on a few other knit-alongs that are running right now. Candace from the Pin Feathers and Pearls podcast is going to have a Stripey Socks knit-along coming up. It may be going on right now. I don't know. I'd have to check to see if my start dates would qualify. But also, Happy Knits is having a St. Patrick's Day knit-along where you knit anything green, and there is green in this. So I would be able to enter her knit along. And also, Casey from the Creative Musings podcast is having a stash socks cal. And this is pretty deep stash, 2015 stash, February 2015 stash. So I'm really tempted. And this is just going to be beautiful. I can't wait to knit these anyway. So these would be fun. Plus, box of socks. And I think that's it. I think that might be it. The other sock knit along I want to join in on is Interim Knits. She's having a knit along for natural socks, so fiber without nylon in it, and possibly non-superwash. I'm not sure. I do have a skeining yarn that would fit that knit along for socks, which I might bring too. So I don't know. We'll have to see. I want everything in it to qualify for somebody's fun thing. So I'll take a look through. I might be these, and it might be this. This might be my Hawaii knitting. I'm not sure. I am going to the Big Island for 5 days, in case you're interested. We're staying a couple nights in Hilo and then a couple nights in Kona, and I'm so excited. We're going to go to Volcanoes National Park. We're going to do a lot of hiking. There's a hot springs or a warm springs that somebody told me about that sounds pretty cool, and it's going to be great. It's going to be really great. One of our friends told us about a bar in Hilo that has really great Hawaiian music that plays every Tuesday, so I'm so excited about that. I think that's going to be Valentine's Day. So hopefully that band is going to be playing that night because I really want to see them. And yeah, I've never been there before. We kind of just did a bunch of research and found a bunch of things we wanted to do. There's petroglyphs there that I really want to see. I'm really interested in things like petroglyphs. There are some temples on the Big Island that were built a very long time ago that I'd like to go see. If there's anything on the Big Island that you have done before that you suggest, let me know in the episode thread. I am going in a couple days. I'm going to bring some internet with me, but, you know, if you think of it and want to post something and let me know what I should do while I'm there, or what I should eat, or where I should go to drink, or where I should go to hike, or whatever, let me know, and I'll check it out. So, the other little travel thing that I wanted to bring up is something that I'm probably not going to do, which I'm super sad about, and that is Stitches West. Stitches West isn't this weekend or the following weekend, but the following weekend, I think. I'm pretty sure it's the weekend after I get back from Hawaii. So I'm not going to be able to go because it'll involve driving to the Bay Area, which is a 5-hour drive, which is where I'm driving to go to Hawaii. So if I went, it would be 3 weekends in a row of driving to and from the Bay Area, which is too much. Plus a hotel, buying yarn, after taking a vacation, it's probably not a good idea. But I really, really want to go, and there's still a chance I'll go. I found myself looking at hotels last night on the internet just in case. So we'll see. But the reason why I was looking into hotels is because I was kind of researching the vendors that were going to be there just to see who I was going to miss out on, because I know I'm going to miss out on some really cool things. So I thought I would talk to you today about the vendors that are going to be at Stitches West, that if I was going to be going, this is who I would be really excited to see. Now, my biggest temptation for possibly going to Stitches West, which I'm totally not going to do, but my biggest temptation to bring me there if I was going to make myself go is that Little Skein and the Big Wool is going to be there doing some, I think it's like fairy tale kits from a bunch of indie dyers. And the one, of course, I'm super excited about is Woolen Vine Yarns did some Last Unicorn yarn for her kits. Oh my god, and it's beautiful. I want it so bad. And the Last Unicorn is one of my favorite stories. I love the book. I love the movie. I watch it here and there. As an adult, it's like one of my favorite movies. It's so amazing. It's like really old style animation with that sort of really classy Disney voiceover style. And oh my god, it's just classiest unicorn ever. And it's got like that old style animation too, where it's really, I don't know how to describe it. I love it though. It's an amazing cartoon. I love it so much. And the fact that she dyed yarn after it, and it's so beautiful. And the reference that she said in her last podcast that she used for the color itself of the yarn is just so cool. It's just so cool. I love it so much, and I really want it. And you can only get it at Stitches West unless you wait 3 months and buy it from Little Skein and the Big Wool on her website after she releases it, you know, because it'll be exclusive to Stitches West people for a few months. But I really want it. I really, really want it. It's the Last Unicorn colorway by Woolen Vine. Also, let's see. I wrote all the stuff down that I want to see at Stitches West. Okay, so Two Guys Yarn Company is going to be there. They're always there. At least every time I've gone to Stitches West, they've been there. And I really, really like their yarn. And I was watching the Knit Girls podcast when their last episode came out a few nights ago. And they revealed on their podcast Two Guys Yarn Company's new mill-spun yarn collection. They've got custom yarn being spun for them at mills in the United States that they're going to start dyeing on and selling. And oh my God, I want to try it so bad. And I went on their website to see if I could buy it, and their website is shut down right now, probably because they're going to be going to Stitches West. And so they're probably going to have that mill-spun yarn there, and I want it so bad. It looks so awesome. So awesome. And I really, really respect an indie dyer that has their own yarn mill-spun for them, which is one of the reasons why I love Jill Draper Makes Stuff so much. And now they're doing it, and oh, I'm so excited. I want to see it so bad. I at least want to look at it all. So I'm sure that, I'm guessing they'll have it there. I'm just guessing they'll have it there, but they'll probably have it there. And I really want to see it. So there's that. And then what else do I want to see? Sincere Sheep is going to be there. Sincere Sheep was that little purple swatch I showed you that I made a sweater out of, some of my favorite yarn I've ever used. I love their yarn, and I never order it on their website. The only time I ever buy it is when I see them vend at shows, and it's just some of the most beautiful yarn. It's made in Napa Valley, and I like it, and they're going to be there. So is Ross Farm. Ross Farm I've never used, but I've always really wanted to use their yarn. A Verb for Keeping Warm is a local to the Bay Area. They're in Berkeley. Natural yarn dyer, and they carry really beautiful yarns. And I've never tried their yarn, but I always look at them when I see them at shows and squish all the yarn and wish I could buy some, and they're going to be there. Green Mountain Spinnery is going to be there. I love Green Mountain Spinnery. I love Green Mountain Spinnery. So they're going to be there. So Space Cadet Yarns, and I like their yarn a lot too. There is one vendor that is going to be there that I feel like, I can't remember who it is. I looked last night at the vendors list and I couldn't figure out who it was, but I found out somewhere, somehow, like a little while ago, that some vendor's going to be there with like a collection of a bunch of indie dyers. And I can't remember who it is, but I really wanted to check it out. So there's that. I don't know what that is, but it's going to be cool, whatever it is. So that's what I'm going to miss out on at Stitches West if I don't go. There's a chance I'll go, but probably not. But it might. We'll see. I don't know. So that's pretty much it for this week. Because I'm going to be on vacation next week, I am going to skip next week's episode because next Friday I will be on vacation and I won't have any recording stuff with me. So you will see me the Friday after that in 2 weeks. So I hope all of you have a wonderful Friday. I hope all of you have a wonderful weekend, a wonderful 2 weeks coming up. Knit a whole bunch of stuff. Knit some socks. Have a really good time. I'll talk to you all next week. Bye.